Welcome back to my channel, everyone. Today we're going to make this cute little ladybug. So what do you need to make this cute little ladybug? You will need some red yarn, some black yarn, very little white yarn, pair of scissors, a darning needle, a stitch marker, and I'm using a 4mm hook. You'll also need a little bit of stuffing. I use fiberfill. So, get your hook and your red yarn ready, and we'll begin. Good grief, I hate it when I do that. Sorry about that. Okay, so first we need to start off with a magic ring. And we need to place 6 single crochets in that magic ring. And close it up. We will be working in the round. Round 2. Whoops. Two single crochets in each stitch around. You should now have 12 stitches. And I place my stitch marker in the last stitch I made. Round 3. One single crochet in the first stitch and 2 single crochets in the second stitch. This is your repeat for this round. One single crochet in the first stitch. Two single crochets in the second stitch. Repeat this all the way around and I'll meet you at the end. You should now have 18 stitches. Round 4. One single crochet in the first stitch, one single crochet in the second stitch, and 2 single crochets in the third stitch. This is your repeat for this round. One single crochet in the first stitch, one single crochet in the second stitch, and two single crochets in the third stitch. Repeat this all the way around, and I'll be back when mine is finished. You should now have 24 stitches. For rounds 5 through 7, we're just going to place one single crochet in each stitch around. I'm going to do these rows. Once I get close to the end, I won't do the last stitch until I meet back up with you, because we're going to change colors on that last stitch. So when I get done, we're going to be changing to black, and I'll be back in a few seconds. You should still have 24 stitches. So this is what it should look like so far. Now we need to add the black. And what I do is I just tie the red and black tails together and double knot them. And then I cut the excess yarn off and stuff the tails down inside. It's an amigurumi, it's not going to go anywhere. So now it's time for the decrease rows. So we're going to place one single crochet in the first stitch, one single crochet in the second stitch, and a single crochet decrease. This is your repeat for this round. One single crochet in the first stitch, one single crochet in the second stitch, and a single crochet decrease in the third and fourth stitch. So do this all the way around, and I'll meet back up with you at the end. You should now have 18 stitches around. Round 9. One single crochet in the first stitch, and then a single crochet decrease. This is your repeat for this row. One single crochet in the first stitch, and then a single crochet decrease in the second and third stitch. Repeat this all the way around, and I'll meet back up with you at the end. You should now have 12 stitches around, and this is what your ladybug should look like so far. So now we're going to stuff it just a little bit. Just take your stuffing and push it in there. You can put as much stuffing in it as you want, but I like to make sure that it's firm, because we will be sewing things onto it here soon. And if you don't put a lot of stuffing in it, then the thread won't be able to catch on to anything to be sewn on, if that makes sense. Alright, I think that's probably enough. So this is our last round. And we're just going to make single crochet decreases all the way around. At the end, you should have 6 stitches. You can go ahead and fasten off, but leave a little bit of a tail because we're going to sew in the circle at the end. And I'll be back when I'm done with mine, or when I'm ready to sew the end together. Alright, this is what you should have. So now we need to place our yarn on our needle. And then we're just going to weave in and out of the stitches all the way around to close up the circle. Once you make it all the way around, just pull and it should close. But I always like to make a knot. And then I'm going to go down inside my stitch and down inside my body. And then I'm going to come out edge of the black. Now we're going to take our black yarn and we're going to give it a stripe. And all we're going to do is go around it like this. Make sure you go in a straight line and then go into your work and come up somewhere. And then we'll make another knot. Don't want that stripe falling off. And then we're just going to go through and hide our stitches. We're just going to go through and hide our tail. Wow. What's up with me and not being able to talk lately? Okay, so once you've gotten it secure, just go ahead and pull on that tail, cut your yarn, and it should suck back into your work. And this is what he looks like so far. He ain't even done and he's cute. Okay, so I hope you kept your black yarn out because we now need to make the spots for the back. We're going to make 4 of them and then we need to make the head. So get your black yarn out, back out. We'll do the spots first to make a magic circle. Chain 1, and all we're going to do is place 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 single crochets in the magic circle. Then we're going to close our magic circle. and slip stitch to the first single crochet. Whoops. Chain one and fasten off. Do leave just a little bit of a tail because you will have to sew this on. You need to make three more of these. So I'm going to make my three more and I'll be back in just a second. Alright, time to make the head. So make your magic circle, chain one, we're going to place one, two, three, whoops, three, four, five, six single crochets in the magic ring, and then we're going to close it. We're going to work in the round again, and we're going to place two single crochets in each stitch around. When I get mine done, then I'll be back. You should now have 12 stitches around. For rounds 3 and 4, we're just going to place one single crochet in each stitch around. At the end of each round, you will still have 12 single crochets. Once you get to the end, go ahead and cut off your yarn, slip stitch into, first slip stitch into your next stitch, and then cut off your yarn. Leave a little bit of a long tail because we will be sewing it onto the body. So once I get my fourth row done, I'll be back. Okay, so this is what you should have, little tiny. Make sure you turn your head right side out. So we're going to take just a tiny amount of stuffing and we're going to stuff it. Put your tail on your hook. And it's time to sew him on. Doesn't matter which end you use, just find a good place. I always put the tail at the bottom of it, and we're just gonna sew it on. I know it's a little hard with the black, but it couldn't be helped. So just go in and out of all of the stitches, making sure that you go in and out of the body too. With it being black, nobody's going to see that you've made mistakes. So this is all you're going to do all the way around. This other tail from your magic circle, you can weave it into, or you can just hide it into the body, or just cut it off. Once I get my head done, I'll return. Okay, got his head on. And I also went ahead and put a few of his spots on. We're going to do those next. I take the tail from the magic ring, and I find where I'm going to put the spot at, and I go in the stitch and then come out somewhere else. And then I just leave it dangling there. Now I take my main tail and I go in into the body. Come out another spot, back into the same place you just came out of, and then go up into the spot on the ladybug, and we're going to sew it together. Just going in and out of the stitches like you did with the head. You'll be putting two spots on each side of the body. Now, if you made a bigger ladybug by using a bigger hook and bigger yarn than what I'm using, well, the red's supposed to be a 4, but I think it's just so old that it's shrunk, maybe? I don't know. Anyway, if you use a bigger hook, you can make a bigger ladybug. And I'll show you at the end, because this one I'm making now, it is made with a 4mm hook, where the very first one that I made it with a 5mm hook, and there's a big difference. So once you get your spot on, it's like sunken in, just go underneath the spot with your needle and pull up. And that will bring it back up. Now these two ends, I tie them together, double knot them. I find the end of the one, and then I trim that tail up, put both tails on my hook, and then I hide the tails in the body. And normally come out the bottom. Then I pull tight and I cut the yarn off. So now I need to go through wherever's like sunken down in and just pull up on it. So this is what I have so far. I got two spots on this half and two spots on this half. Now we need to make his eyes and then he's done. So get your white yarn out. And we're going to put it on our needles. We're going to do a French knot in the eyes to make the eyes. And I really don't need this much yarn. So what you do is you come in through like the outside of the head and find the hole that you're going to go into. I think I'm going to go in the second row. Bring your yarn through. Leave a little tail on the outside of his head. Then we're going to grab our needle and place it close to the head. And we're going to wrap the white yarn around the needle 3 times. And then go over a couple of stitches and go back down inside the head and come out somewhere else. And pull all that yarn through that spot. And this is what you get. And that's called a French knot. So now we're going to go on the other side of the head, and we're going to do the same thing. So I'm going 4 holes from the first eye, and I'm going to make another French knot. So I'm going to put my needle close to my head, and I'm going to wrap the yarn around 3 times. And then I'm going to go down a couple fibers over and go back into the head and come out somewhere else. And make that French knot. And 2, if you get them too tight in there, then you can put your needle in there and just pull it up a little bit and it will bring it back up. And there he has eyes. His head's a little crooked. Oh, well, he can be a crooked ladybug. So now, I'm just going to take my tail and come out the same spot that I did the first tail. Knot the 2 together. Cut the excess yarn off and then hide my yarn in my work. Come out the bottom. The excess off. And I pulled an eyeball out. I pulled just a little too tight and my eye sucked in. Come on, come back out here. Can't have a ladybug with one eye. And I don't want to do it again. There. Now he's got 2 eyes again. Okay, so this is what your ladybug should look like, minus the crooked head. See, I got the eyeballs. I didn't get the eyeballs. Oh, well, he's my cricket eyeball. We'll call him Cricket Eye. So we're not completely done with this ladybug. We are going to do something else with him, but for today, he's done. And I hope you were able to follow along with me, okay? I've had some complaints that my tutorials are too hard and nobody can follow along with them. So I'd greatly appreciate it if you've watched this video and made this ladybug. Can you tell me in the comments if it was easy or if it was too hard? I would like to show you what we're making next. It will be this flower square. This will be flower square 7, I do believe. So, if you're new to my channel and like what we made here today, I do a lot of different things on my channel. Please consider subscribing. I would appreciate it if you gave this video a thumbs up and comment below. If you have friends that like ladybugs, go ahead and share it. You can share all of my videos. That would be so awesome. Thank you so much for watching my video. Please be safe out there. Until next time, bye.